examples he's going to use. And the challenge will be, will you know what those are?
Okay, good morning, everyone. Good morning, dear colleagues. It will be quite simple presentation, but very, very important, and I prove it. And at the beginning, I would like again to mention what I did yesterday in my presentation, that for normal people who is working in nuclear organization, difference between information and explicit knowledge, there is no difference, I would say. Even as I mentioned, they don't like and they don't want to use this terminology as explicit, implicit. That is why immediately at the beginning I would say that I will use term or word in information, but we should understand that information equal explicit knowledge. Area of information management is very, very wide. Just it's several clusters I did show you on this slide. It's nuclear information specifics, international nuclear information resources, information flow management, IT tools and systems, knowledge organization systems, digital preservation, trusted and non-trusted information resources, 3D modeling, international standards, a lot. And for each of this element in our portfolio, there is special presentation. But of course, today, no time, first of all, but fortunately, Dobby, who will follow my presentation and will present additional topic tomorrow, will cover many other aspects about information management. Now we should understand that we are living at the time of information. It means around us, a lot of information, and it's so crucial for our life that we should be able to manage it in right way. This is extremely important. I'm assistant professor in Moscow University, and in my course for students, there is special two lectures how to manage personal information, because it's quite important. Sometimes we are very smart working with computer, with gadgets, but nevertheless, sometimes we are not able effectively manage our personal information. This is very important also to understand. What does it mean, information management? There are a lot of definitions you can find on internet. I like just the last one, that focus of information management is just ability of any organization to capture, manage, preserve, store, and deliver information to people, to their staff. My presentation will follow this goal, how to capture, manage, preserve, store, and deliver. It means provide access. We should also understand, and it was mentioned several times, that nuclear information, the nuclear area is very complex and multidisciplinary. It means that if we are talking about general approach to managing nuclear information, our databases is very, very big. And it will be a special presentation about international nuclear information system, which already contain over 4 million units or record about different published and unpublished materials. And of course, we should also understand that nuclear area is very sensitive, and that is why at least part of information, nuclear information, should be properly protected. Okay, Another specific of nuclear information that we have a lot of different and various sources of information. It's from meeting, from nuclear power plants, from other facilities, in atomic agency, energy agency. There is even EQZS system, analytical control management information system. It's information system about samples from different country, mushrooms, leaves, soil. Just about it was created after Chernobyl accident, just to store and to analyze dynamic of radioactivity in different places. And different type of information needs different type of management. Information management value chain. Preservation, sharing, integration, maintenance. It means, first of all, to make, to preserve and make it available. After that, share, it should be available for around, for all people, at least in organization. It should be integrated with other information resources, either within the organization or even outside. And of course, maintenance is quite important, and I will give you some example when big organization failed because they forgot about maintenance of information. Focus on my presentation will be on information preservation. It means the main phases of this activity, how to select and capture information, how to organize in proper way, how to store. It's many possibilities, how to retrieve and again maintain. And of course, on each stage, I don't want to talk specially, it should be some quality control implemented. Okay, preservation of information. It started many thousand years ago. This is a very good example. Stone in Egypt, and due to that some people did preservation, we know something about what was in the past. That is why role of preservation is tremendously important in history of our world. But of course, it's quite expensive, and we know also that another type of information was stored on papyrus. But nevertheless, media of papyrus as a media is not reliable as a stone. And we know that it was famous library in Alexandria. It has been burned because papyrus is paper. It's very, very reliable, unfortunately. And we lost a lot of information just because there was no, at that time, activity how to maintain collection. Our world, information world, is very dynamical. And for last 40 years, its progress was tremendous. It was paper. After that, maybe you don't know, but I started working with computer ICL 1906 in my institute in 1970 with Perfocard. After that, we moved to Perfolent. This is already was some kind of progress. After that, magnetic tape. This is just example, illustration that the first hard disk was innovated by IBM in 1956. It was weight 1 ton, 1,000 kilogram, and this disk could store 8 photo. Could you imagine? But nevertheless, at my time, we started with magnetic tape. After that, it was floppy disk. And now we have solid state disk, hard disk, and so on. Bernoulli box. What is the main goals of preservation? In 2002, I was in Cornell University and I participated in special project how to clarify procedure of digital preservation, even to converting paper-based document in digital form. And we define these three items as main goal of preservation. First of all, to select most valuable information. Yesterday we talked about tacit knowledge, to select and capture critical tacit knowledge in information, most valuable information. Ensure that it remains readable, accessible, and understandable. It means media should be reliable and it should be maintainable. And manage technological change. It's also very, very important. Example, paper-based. If I destroy something, is it readable? Yes. Is it understandable? Yes. If I take, for example, CD-ROM and I destroyed everything, it's not readable, not understandable. I can show you my personal magnetic tape. Yeah. It's already older than 30 years, probably, but I'm keeping. Is it readable?
No.
Probably I can find some reader. But is it understandable? I think no. Because I can read it, but it will be sequence on 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, and what? I don't remember what I stored here. But at that time, 40 years ago, I was very proud to have personal magnetic tape. Guess memory of this capacity in kilobytes, megabytes, just 10 megabytes. Guess 100, 1 gigabyte, 1 kilobyte.
10 kilobyte?
10 megabyte. 10 megabyte?
Yeah.
No, it's 80 megabyte. 80. It's 80 megabyte. Now I can show you, this is one, next one generation, it's floppy disk. It's 1.2 megabyte. This is flexible, this is more reliable, I would say, media than CD-ROM or DVD. This is next generation, three inch, 1.44 megabyte. I have something in my pocket. This is 256 giga. Where is 256 giga? Multiply by 3,000. Could you imagine? I need 3,000 magnetic tape, or only this one. This is fantastic, but nevertheless, we should think what is reliable, what is not reliable, because old technology sometimes more reliable. Yesterday we saw it. This was destroyed. This is always very reliable. Okay, let's go back to topic. I created some problem. Selection of information. Why select? Because quite important that this information will be needed in the future. Example, nuclear power station. Now, majority of nuclear power station moved from analog technology to digital technology. It means that some information about how to maintain analog equipment already is not valid and will not be valid in the future. We also should think that preservation has some cost. That is why quite important to estimate how much money and resources is needed for digitizing or, and for maintenance. Legal issue also. And that is why before starting this project of preservation, it is necessary to think about possible criteria how to select information. Next, organize. It is necessary to describe information, and there is special methodology. It was used already, I don't know, for 50, maybe even more years, maybe 100 even. Metadata. Metadata is structured data about data. We know that a lot of bibliographical databases still available in the world, in the information world, and description of content, description of document, this is a typical example of metadata. By the way, I forgot one thing. It's very important because we will talk about maintenance, but maybe in advance I will tell you about magnetic tape, about our agency, because International Atomic Agency, created archive, started creating a digital archive starting from 1970, when first IBM computer was installed in agency. And within long period of time, they created archive with magnetic tapes in Cybersdorf, just to be on distance. Now this archive, it's totally have more than 100,000 magnetic tapes. 100,000 magnetic tape with special room, special condition, humidity, temperature, but nobody knows what is inside now. Nobody. And even not possible, because movement to new technologies, server, client, architecture was so fast, they forgot about it. And that is why, what to do with this archive? It's $1 million was spent to create this archive. Just I want to stress that maintenance, if you are creating some product, maintain it. Because if there is no, it's very simple word, but nevertheless, after that, you can just destroy all efforts what was done before. It's just nothing. It was a waste of money, waste of time. And till now, nobody can make a decision just to throw it away. Who knows? Who knows? But it's absolutely obvious that nothing will happen. Okay, let's go to metadata. This is just a record from International Nuclear Information System about article Fermi, Future of Atomic Energy. This is very classical article, because Enrico Fermi, in reality, it's father of nuclear energy, if you know, because he is the first who developed and built a research reactor, uranium, in 1942. And after that, he wrote this this article in May 1946, and till now it's valid, this article. But no, I want to just to show what does it mean, metadata. Title of article, it's one element of metadata. After that, name of author, where it was done, this article, subject, energy planning, source, where it could be found now. Type of literature, where it was published, which country, which language, keywords. This is typical metadata, but it's very simple. But nevertheless, now technology allows to index full text. But nevertheless, there are a lot of information, photographs, some kind of schemes, technical documentation special, which should be described with metadata. Metadata, there are three types of metadata: administrative metadata, descriptive, and structured. Normally, we are using in our digital repository, library, databases, only two types of metadata. It's administrative metadata, which described format, maybe rights, who allowed to access this information, condition, software, and descriptive metadata. This is most classical, because descriptive metadata, as I did show on previous slide, described content and document itself. Who created this document, where it could be found, and so on. And abstract, for example, about what this document was written. And structure and data is very rare used. It's structure of, when we are talking, storing very complicated information. Normally, it's a mathematical area, chemical area with formulas, and so on. Now there are plenty of formats. This is just most popular, MARS, or MARC, machine readable cataloging. This is the first format, machine readable, and for example, International Nuclear Information System, INIS, it's adapted this format. But most popular now, it's de facto standard, market standard in Dublin Core. But nevertheless, more and more database owner use XML extended markup language just to describe the records. Just an example, the Dublin Core is only 15 elements, is very simple, title, subject, description, and so I don't want to go to details. You can find this information on the internet very easily. But nevertheless, I can say that now it's as a market standard already. Store. It's a very important environment. If we are talking about analog information, it should be special room with special condition, temperature, and for example, INIS still keeping huge collection of microfiche in IAEA, and also it special condition. Media, on which media? Because it magnetic tape or DVD or hard drive, everything is needed some kind of maintenance. We will talk a little bit later. Each format, because again, I would say that agency at IAEA has not only magnetic tape for archive. They also have archive on floppy disk, because when first personal computer were installed, it was WANG systems. There was no hard drive, and everything was on floppy disk. And word processing was not Microsoft. Microsoft was not at that time so powerful as now. It was display writer. It was WordStar. You don't know even such name. It was WordPerfect, but now it's, I tried to find some converter, but could not, because if we selected some format, think about that in future, it should be readable and understandable. Of course, there is text and image, but now, fortunately, PDF, quite universal standard. It cover many, many requirements, and it became ISO standard. It means if you use PDF, why we should try to use ISO standard? Because it means longevity should be ensured, will be ensured. It means for long, for maybe 20, 50 years, definitely this format will be supported. Provide access. Of course, now internet, web, it's the best, but until now exists also the Z3950 protocol, what was developed when before internet, and there are special information scientific nets as STN, as Dialog, which use until now this protocol to communicate and to provide interconnection between different databases. Offline, CD, DVD, disks. It's a lot of possibilities. Of course, not memory sticks, because it's not reliable media at all. When we provide access, it could be full text access, it could be through metadata. For example, INIS provide us with possibility. Sorry, Dobby, that I am I was involved so much in IMIS, but I cannot, and it's a good example that provide both possibility to search through metadata and full text. Okay, of course, now there is a solved problem with portability. Independently on operational system, you can work with any information system. Now, majority of system has multi-lingual interface, even translation on flight. It could be managed access rights very easily, and so on. Maintenance, extremely important to ensure longevity. Control, if we have some media, paper, magnetic media, it is necessary to control from time to time. And sometimes to even to refresh to for magnetic tape, for example, to read at least. Migration. Migration from one media to another, from CD to DVD, from DVD to hard disk, from hard disk to clouds, for example. And emulation. Emulation, when we are talking about special type of information as computer codes. There is partner of INIS near data bank. And there is very big collection of computer codes for nuclear area, around 4,000. And this is very smart organization, I would say, because they're not only keeping these codes. When new operational system coming, they are checking whether code is can operate under new operational system. If not, they either modify or to create virtual machine with previous operational systems. This is very important. Oh, this is example. Example, INIS. INIS is pioneer of knowledge preservation or information preservation. They started with chemical technology. This is microfiche. Have you seen microfiche? Up to 60 pages on each. This is collection contain 2.5 million of this microfiche. It's around 25 or 30 even million pages. And I don't know exactly status, Dobby will tell probably, but I was I participated in initial stage to convert this collection into digital form. And we started this in cooperation with Oak Ridge INIS Center and with French INIS Center in its Commissary of Atomic Energy of France. And when I was, when I left agency and retired from the agency in 2008, we digitized approximately 65% of the collection. Probably now it's 100. Of course, not all collection is in accessible free, but nevertheless, I think it's a huge, and many of documents on this collection available only from this system. It's not anymore available in other country, because majority of the collection, it's not published information, reports, dissertation, and so on. Okay, IT solution, because we talked about formats, but quite important where to store, because providing access, it means make collection active. If collection is active, it will be immediately by user recognized when something wrong with this collection. This is important. And what for we are doing archive? To deliver information to our users, to our staff. That is why information should be active. And there are plenty of different systems. And this is just types, document management system, how to deal with documents, how to store a different version of the same documents, digital repository and libraries. There are a lot of software, even free, MIT developed DSpace, Cornell University developed Pandora, which allows not only provide access and store information, also to process of preservation of information. Content management system, you know, expert system, very important, because sometimes knowledge is of expert or written is based on rules. If something wrong, do this one. If this happened, do this one. Rule-based system, it's expert system. It's special type of information. Knowledge bases and portals. Dobby will mention that there is agency nuclear portal nucleus. It's free. You can register and find a lot of useful information from the agency. This is just example, again, INIS, when we can see a bibliographical description metadata and immediately go to full text. This is example, it's article of Susan Eisenhower about his father, president of United States, who in 1953 in UN on General Assembly suggested to create special international mechanism, and after that International Atomic Energy Agency was established. Another example, Nuclear Web Archive. This was initiative of Nuclear Knowledge Management Section. It started in 2008 when a special crawler captured information from trusted information sources on the internet to create archive. Now it's terabytes of information, but unfortunately maintenance was stopped when people who started with this project left this section. This is not late. It could be again, how to say, refreshed, but nevertheless, now it will be just archive. But it's very it was very important initiative, because a lot of information on internet, it's not exist forever. That is why sometimes important information, it is necessary to capture on time and to store and to make it available. Okay, but nevertheless, until now, not only digital technology now under progress and under development and with a lot of innovation. There is also quite interesting efforts. This is developed high density analog storage devices in Los Alamos. It's very, how to say, small nickel plate. 3-inch just size, but it can store over 350,000 pages. And it could be special equipment to read it and to index, but nevertheless also it is possible just with normal microscope to read. This is absolutely super reliable media. Temperature threshold up to 500,000 degree, it will not be destroyed, and of course minus also up to 0 degree Kelvin. This is another example, and on one this 3-inch plate was stored Bible on all language. On all languages. It means that analog people thinking, because digital media is not unfortunately super reliable, and most important information, of course we cannot, we can use stone, but it's better to use new technology, but it's some people do it. Okay, I said that nuclear information is very sensitive, and it is necessary to protect. There is special guidance which was published, I think, last year by the agency, by the IAEA. And if you have some problem, if you are doing something in this direction, I would recommend this publication to you. About international standards. When we started digitization of our collection on microfiche and other. We did a lot in the IAEA. We used these two standards. At that time, in 2008, they were not ISO standard, but now from 2012, they started, they became as international standards. First standard is open archival information system, and second, it's trusted digital repository. This is kind of framework, how to work, stages, requirements, processes, and so on. By the way, both this standard was initiated by NASA in early 2000, because they have millions and millions of photos from satellites, from telescopes, and it was necessary how to organize and to make it available in digital form. That is why they initiated establishment of these standards. Okay, summary. Information preservation is a very complex process with several important stages. But each stage should be carefully done, performed. Selection, capturing, organizing, providing access. Because process of preservation, it's not one-time task. If you started preservation, you should think about future. First of all, how to do it in the best quality. And second, how to maintain and how to transfer activity of maintenance of database to future generation. All this efforts, time, everything will be destroyed. Of course, there are a lot of methods and tools how to do it. And it's up to you to select most adequate to your requirements, to your organization. Maintenance of information is very crucial, and thanks people who did it for Stone, and now information was delivered because of this effort to us. And I would say principle and responsibility for this project. Everyone does not have to do everything, we should understand. Everything does not have to be done at once. Someone must be willing to take a lead on almost all steps, because leadership is extremely important. Small steps are usually better than no steps at all, and preservation should not be postponed until a perfect solution appears. Sometimes we can see it in our lives that people wait, oh, in 2 years, next year will be very good software, and after that we will start. It will be cheaper. Don't wait. It's better to make a first step now than postpone, and after that maybe just do nothing. Okay. Thank you very much.